Visible for miles, NASA's new Launch Complex 39, home launch base for Project Apollo, is the most advanced facility of its type known in the free world. Its nucleus is the gigantic vehicle assembly building, called the VAB, the biggest building on Earth. 525 feet tall, it covers almost 8 acres. The volume it encloses would swallow up the Pentagon, with almost enough room left over for Chicago's merchandise mart. The way to the launch pads is as broad as the Jersey Turnpike. The pads, big as battleships, lie hard by the Atlantic. American astronauts will depart from here, bound for the moon and back. The space age is here now, no longer just around the corner. And America has entered it with gusto and style. Single Army Corps of Engineers, Canaveral District, awarded the basic construction contract for the colossal building to a joint venture team of Morrison Knutson Company, Perini and Hardiman in January 1964. Morrison Knutson, or MK, is the sponsor of the joint venture. Management and progress are the responsibilities of MK, one of the largest and most widely experienced construction organizations in the world. American Bridge Division of U.S. Steel fabricates and erects the framework under a separate and prior contract. It's been assigned to MK and Associates for purpose of administration and for coordinating various work programs on the job. The skeleton is made up from about 45,000 individual members. As to the west doorway. It's built to handle the world's biggest transport machines, the crawler transporters carrying the rocket, spacecraft, and the mobile launchers. Load limits, 17.5 million pounds. Lanes are on 90-foot centers. They're over 6 feet thick. Can be used on space projects for years to come. The Launch Control Center is the command post for rocket firing. Electrical conduit runs to all points of the complex. All construction operations on the building are keyed to engineering control. Thousands of drawings, scores of draftsmen, even one pert engineering checker. Schedules are rigid, with 49 separate dates for completion of almost 3,000 different work items. Construction was born with a calloused fist, grew up in work clothes, and it graduated in modern math and computerized control. So, plot today's progress runs on a critical path. 40 acres of floors. 57,000 tons. 1 million high-strength bolts. Engineering control. Job progress, steel in the sky, 2,000 men at work. The brawniest building in the world, square-hipped to rebuff any hurricanes that might blow in from the Atlantic. A drab paint covers the structural steel, wards off the corrosive mists from the sea. The panels of insulated aluminum siding also resist salt air. Each is about 20 feet long. They cover most of the outer walls, more than 12,000 panels. This truss for a 250-ton crane will roost near the ceiling of the high bay, almost 500 feet straight up. there are three overhead cranes. They'll pick up and shuffle the huge rocket stages to stack them up one on top of the other. Altogether, there'll be 70 lifting devices, large and small. But then, six football fields would fit on the main floor. Each of the high bay doors will tower 456 feet. There's a symphony in steel on the Florida coast, a $101 million performance under the stars, directed by the men of MK, supervised by the Corps of Engineers for NASA. The instruments are the tools of heavy construction, the minds, the hands, the machines. The tower holds a 250,000 gallon water supply. The two crawlers, built by others, would cover a football field. The mobile launchers, by still other contractors, are science fiction in steel. The work platforms which equip the high bays of the building are assembled in sections outdoors. They'll surround the rocket. The utility annex houses auxiliary machinery for power, heating, steam, and air conditioning. Without climate conditioning, clouds could form in some inner areas of the colossal building. Weather right, it might even rain indoors. Of Egypt, built out of massive stone, has stood for centuries as the biggest building on earth. It contains over 96 million cubic feet. But this building encloses more than 129 million cubic feet. And that's quite a monument to Yankee engineering, management skill, and plain get-it-done work. It grew up in but 2 years. In itself, it's the focal point of a fascinating stage of history. The vast transfer aisle is ready for business. The work platform stacked in the high bay wait to hug the midriff of giant Saturn V. Space and time are related in this great new age, but construction and time have always been married. Our mightiest ground facility and the world's biggest building comes into full stature right on schedule. Launch Control Center is ready. Testing out a dry run. The crawler transporters are operational. Progress on the mobile service structure is on schedule. A little over 400 feet tall, it's probably the world's biggest movable land object. Compare, say, to the height of a 40-story building. It supports work platforms, big as a house, for use by technicians on the launch pad. They'll open up to surround the vehicle for servicing and final checkout. They move individually and rise to any height needed. The project is a separate construction contract of MK and Associates. The crawler transporter will bodily pick up the 12 million pound tower and move it out onto the launch pad. Another interesting space-age job of MK's men involves building fueling systems at the pad. Stainless steel lines and special couplers for charging the lunar excursion module require utmost precision. Space missions depend in large measure on some down-to-earth problems. Immaculate, dependable fueling lines, and the exacting workmanship locked into their groundwork. For from this threshold of the future, American astronauts will roar off from Earth for the planets, the stars, and the universe. The first trip to the pad is for checkout and practice only. It proves out a theory. Ground speed is 1 mile an hour. Scintillating though it is, the present is but prologue. While future astronauts find their rendezvous with the stars, the men of science, engineering, and construction will endlessly conceive, design, and build ever better facilities to help set man free from the confines of his own Earth.
T-minus 25, 24, 23, 22, 21, 20, 19, 18, 17, guidance release, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, we have ignition sequence start. The engine's now building up to 7.7 million pounds of
thrust. All engines running. Launch commit and liftoff.
We have a launch commit and we have a liftoff. The swing arm is moving back. We clear the tower.
Roger, clear the tower.
Houston is now controlling.
Oh, we have good thrust in all five.
Roger.
Pitch and roll program started.
Roger.
16 now, maneuvering to its proper flight path attitude. Mark 27 seconds.